While addressing a joint press conference between members of parliament, the Minister of Health and civil society organizations in commemoration of the World Free Alcohol Day that is usually held on 3rd October annually, the calls to regulate alcohol drinking hours came top on agenda as all stakeholders emphasized the need to limit drinking hours in a way to reduce alcoholism that is a danger to the society.
We want to reduce the availability of alcohol so that with specific times for drinking are agreed. Some of you, this place are young. Some of us who were there during Amin's time, you remember? During Amin's time, you could not go to a bar before, was it 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock? If they found you in a bar in the morning, they will arrest you.
They cause accidents. People drink the whole night up to morning. Today morning, I was going for my usual exercise. 6:30, along Akashi. So many boda-bodas waiting for drunkards to transport drunkards away from the bar at 6:30 a.m.
Dr. Henry Mwebesa, the Director General Health Services, urged Ugandans not to take pride in being the leading alcohol consumers in Africa, saying the harm alcoholism is having on the nation's health sector is enormous.
Now the latest, which is the worst, is that we have been leading in Africa as the biggest alcohol consumers. And that's really not a trophy we are very proud about. We should be proud about these trophies of sports and what.
Sarah Opendi, who was granted leave in November 2022 by Parliament to table the Alcohol Control Bill, announced that very soon the bill will be presented to the floor of Parliament for the second reading. She echoed that the intention is not stopping the consumption of alcohol, but regulating the consumption.
Over consumption of alcohol is a leading cause of non-communicable diseases like high blood pressure, like diabetes, mental disorders, but also we are aware that accidents in this country have been as a result of consumption of alcohol and driving while drunk.
In the proposed alcohol control bill, Opendi is seeking to prohibit the manufacture and sale of alcohol without a license and proposed to have anyone found flouting this provision to face a fine of 500 currency points, equivalent to 10 million shillings, or imprisonment not exceeding 5 years or both.
Those who are producing this alcohol should be people who are licensed. People who are not producing alcohol that is adulterated, alcohol that has other substances that can cause adverse effects on the health of the population.
It is also seeking to impose a timeline within which alcohol consumers are in position to consume their drink by having the sale not take place before midday and beyond 6 p.m. and a fine of 20 million shillings or imprisonment for 10 years are being proposed. The executive director of National Care Center backed the enactment of the Alcohol Control Bill, especially on the provision of banning drinking of alcohol amongst people below 18 years. The lawmaker is seeking to bar the sale of alcohol inside passenger vehicles, sale to law enforcement officers, persons below 18 years, and any contravention of the said laws, attracting monetary fines and jail sentences ranging between 3 to 10 years.
Below the 18, not drinking will be emphasized. There is too much drinking, as my colleague there said, among young people. I have asked them, 5 years they drink alcohol, and you know when we are growing, alcoholism affects our brain cells.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.